You are talking anything? You are in mute.
No, I have to start yet. Just looking for what I have to teach.
Okay.
Okay, so I'll start now. We'll start with cyber security. From the previous things we have done most except for database. I think database management I have not done, and some parts from the other topics, but mostly it is done. Now we'll start with cyber security. Let me start with I had told you how to prevent hacking and all. I'll explain. First thing, I'll start with how to find out whether a website is correct or wrong. So suppose I open amazon.in here. Wait, better I'll open Flipkart. Okay, so the first thing that you have to see is the URL. As you can see, it has got four main components: HTTPS, then www, then the name of the company, and then .com. Am I audible?
Yes.
Okay. Just a minute. Some people want to join. Okay. So the first thing that you have to check is the URL. This is called URL, Uniform Resource Locator, I guess. Wait. Uniform Resource Locator. This is like an address. Every website will have its own address. Like this is flipkart.com. There is one amazon.in. Then there is also Amazon.
Voice is not clearly audible.
Are others able to hear me? Maybe you have network issue. Are others able to hear me?
Yes.
Okay, then I think you are facing network issues. Those who are not able to hear me, I guess they are facing network issues because I am using broadband. My signal should be fine. Okay, so I'll tell you. See, this is amazon.com. This is amazon.in. Then there will be another Amazon for UK as well. That is for United Kingdom. Yeah, I think you have network issues. Others are able to hear me. If other people are not able to hear me, please let me know. Is there anybody else who is not able to hear me clearly? Okay, others are able to hear me clearly. I think you have got network issues. Okay, so this you see here. The website has got, if I were to remove the other part, this is what Amazon from UK would look like, from United Kingdom. This is how from America would look, and this is how from India would look.
Others, can you hear him?
Can others hear me? Just tell me once.
Yes.
Okay. So this has got four parts mainly. That is HTTPS, then www, then the name of the website, and a suffix .in, or as you can see here .com, or as you can see here .co.uk. So you have to look in these four parts itself. Okay, first HTTPS or not. Normally the websites will have HTTPS. S stands for secure or security. Just a second, I'll check it. Secure. HTTPS S stands for secure, which means the website is secure. They have to purchase a certificate. Like if I click here, this shows connection is secure. However, that is not all. There are many other things that you have to check in the website, because this secure or a security certificate can be bought easily. Next thing is www dot is there or not. Most of the websites will have, some might not have. Then you have to see amazon.com. What is the name? Like, is it Amazon, or it could just be a copy such as Amazon, or it could be a copy Amazon. Okay, so these are the small things you have to check before entering your details. And after this, you have to see what the suffix is, whether it is .in, .com or .co.uk. Most of the times, if it is .co.uk, then you should understand it is a website of United Kingdom. If it is .in as here, then you should understand that it stands for India. Like here, it is flipkart.com because they do not have many websites. They have only one website. Now, next, like if I open this website, okay, this is Karnataka government's website. You will see here, it has got many parts. First is HTTPS, as I said. Then from here to here, I'll tell you, this is the main part. BCWD is one part. Karnataka is one part. GOV is one part. And IN is one part. After that is slash, okay. After this thing, like after the slash, you can see the slash clearly. You can see what I have highlighted here. In case you are not able to see, just a minute. Okay. So I'll just copy some other website. So this is a website that I have copied. I will just make small changes so that you understand it better. Okay, so this is a website link URL that I have copied. Now see, like I told you, it has got four main parts. Okay, it has got four main parts. The first one is HTTPS, then comes www. Then comes the name of the company or the website, and then there will be .com, .in, .uk, .gov and etc. other things. Now from www. Okay, from here till the first slash, till here, you have to observe this part to find out whether a website is fake or real. Okay, this part after www. Till you get the first slash, in this case after .com, and in this case, just a minute. In this case, as you can see, after it was www was supposed to be there, but it didn't come. It doesn't matter. Okay, in this case, I will take HTTPS. Okay, from here till the first slash. This is the first slash. I hope I'm clear. Okay. Till the first slash, you have to observe. This much you understood, till where you are supposed to see the website name, URL name. Are you clear what I meant? Till the first dash, you have to see till the first dash, okay? See, till here, this is the first dash after www or HTTPS. Did you understand what I'm trying to say? What you have to see? Did you understand what you have to see?
Yes.
Okay, so you have to see that. Now I will leave Amazon part. I will explain with this government website. Now you can see this is BCWD. Leave about that. Then comes Karnataka. That is important. Then comes GOV and .in. If a website has got GOV between two dots, okay, here one dot, here one dot, then it means it is a government website. Okay, if it has got it between two dots before the first slash, after HTTPS and after www, if there is a GOV between two dots and it is supposed to be just before in or just before com, and I'll show you another example. Just a minute. I'm forgetting. So I you can see this one. Here what happens, nih.gov, even this is fine, okay? If gov is at the end or it is supposed to be second last, okay? Understood? Gov is in the second last, then it is a government website. Then after that, you can have .in, .com, .uk or something. But if gov is in the second last or completely last, as in this, here it is second last, here it is completely last, then these websites are maintained by the government. This particular is maintained by America government. And this is maintained by government of India. Under that, Karnataka, under that comes BCWD. Did you understand how it works? Did you understand?
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
It is like first India. You have to see the first dash after www or HTTP. So first India, under that Indian government, under that Karnataka, and under that BCWD, this is the department, okay, which is controlling the information present on this particular website, which means this website is good because its ending shows it has got government. Similarly, if I were to open some other website, suppose I open Aadhaar card website, okay. So you can see here, if I have opened Aadhaar card website, then you can see here that it ends with India government and then whichever department controls it. Now, because Aadhaar is for throughout India, it has not got Karnataka or Tamil Nadu or something else. However, if I were to open the ration card department, then it will look like this. This is India. NIC stands for National Informatics Center or something like that. I don't know what exactly. It should be mentioned here. Wait. National Informatics Center, NIC. Okay. So if any website has got these two suffix before the first dash, see here, after HTTPS, it is the first dash here. So before that, it means India, under India NIC, or if you get under India GOV, then that website is from government, or NIC, then that website is from government. So National Informatics Center is maintaining it, under that Karnataka government is maintaining it, and in Karnataka government this particular department is maintaining it. Clear? That is how you find out whether a website is from government or not, or like you find out whether a website is correct or wrong. Did you understand?
Yes.
Okay. Just a minute. Now, like one of my friend sent me a link that said students are getting free laptops, but in that particular website there was no GOV and no NIC, which means it is not from the government. Even if it was from the government, I don't know what the website is. Let me check if I have the link or not, because I asked her to delete it. But if it's there, I'll show you some other features from which you can find out whether a website is fake or what. Just a minute. Okay, also pay attention to the details. The logo, okay. It might be Amazon.in, but this logo might not be present there, or it might be Flipkart and this plus sign might not be there. And check for the grammar. A good website will always have good grammar, whereas in a fake website, they just create it. They won't look after so much of this thing. They won't care much about grammar, because one or the other person will fall for it. Just a minute, I'm looking for the website. Okay, so I got it. I'll just show you that website and how you can spot that it is a fake website. Okay, so this is the website that my friend sent me. Now, how do I find out whether it's a... You can see the screen, right? Clearly?
Yes.
Okay, so I'll tell you how I find out this is a fake website or not. First of all, like I told you, any website, if like I was to take that BCWD website, then just a minute. There can be many parts. Just give me a second. Okay, so if I take out the first, like here you can see there are many parts. If after the first dash I remove the part, okay, after the first dash I remove the parts and press enter, I will get the main page. Okay, in that also, if I remove BCWD, the first part, I will get probably Karnataka government's website. Okay, now in that also, if I remove Karnataka, I don't know if it will work or not, but if I just remove Karnataka and type gov.in. Okay, so this does not work. That was the least I can access. Okay, which means you can remove part by part and you'll get some or the other thing. However, here, when you check here, there is just .xyz and then there is nothing in front, which means this website has got just one page. Now I'll give you what page means. Okay, I'll make you understand what page means. See, like if you open this website, there are many different pages. Scholarships, hostels, training programs, each page, if you click, you will get different link here. Okay, you will get different link, but in this and you can always remove the part after the first dash and you will go back to the home page. However, what happened here is it is just one single page. There are no other parts in this website. First thing, if this was really a government program, there would be multiple pages linking each other. Second thing, just a minute, free laptop. Now, grammar, free laptops for students. It is not going to be one laptop for multiple students. If they are distributing, they'll distribute for each student separately. Then students, laptops, support. Student, here, even here, there is some grammar mistake. Students, laptops, support. It shouldn't be like that. Then how to qualify for the student's laptop is to complete the registration below. Even this sentence is wrong. If it was really a government's website, they would look after the grammar part, be part of the successful. Here, there shouldn't be a capital P. It should be a small p. Successful student that will receive a laptop to help them. Be part that will receive a laptop to help them in learning. The whole sentence is wrong actually. If you knew English properly, you could make out that the whole sentence itself is wrong. You must be a student, age bracket 10 to 50 years. Now understand, 50 year student will get a laptop from government. That is not possible, because once you attain the age of 25 to 30, government expects you to earn and buy laptop yourself. And what are their criteria? First thing, you should be a student up to this age. Second thing, you should be able to read and write. That's it, nothing else. And they are asking you to register, but that cannot happen. Like if government is giving out something, they will look at your marks. They won't just ask if you know to read and write. And education level, okay. Secondary school, undergraduate, master's, PhD, college, high school. College is same as undergraduate, high school is same as secondary school. So there are many mistakes in this website. And see what they are saying. If you get this question right, you will automatically qualify for the laptop, which means, and this is a very simple question. It is hard to believe that you will solve this question and get the laptop. Okay. Now you must be thinking, if they are not giving you a laptop, then why should we enter all these things? So let me just show you why we have to enter all these things. I'll just enter my details and I'll show you why. First of all, you should not fill in your details. But I'll just show you. Okay, so now they'll ask you different things like your phone number, your home address, date of birth, education level, etc. Now you might think, okay, what's wrong in giving phone number? Well, when you give your phone numbers, you will get calls from customer care. You must be irritated from about loans, credit cards, home loan, this, that and all. That is how they get your number, because you have filled this form. Second thing, date of birth, education level and other things. You should never put these details, because these details can be used to hack your phone. They can click on forgot password on different websites and find out passwords. Probably you might have set your date of birth or your home address or education level or something you must have put as your password. So they will be able to find out. You should not fill these forms. And you, most of the times you will get this thing, a timeline. You have to finish before that. That is so that in a hurry, you don't have enough time and you fill in the details. Okay, that is how you find out whether a website is fake or not. Then some of the things that I wanted to tell you, just a minute, let me check. I had noted it down. Okay, Android. So many people say that Android is iOS is better than Android. But let me tell you, Google conducts King Prize. See here, Google told they will pay you $1 million if you can hack its phones. So now you must think it yourself. If the company itself is saying, and this is not some normal website, this is Forbes website. It is very reputed. Like I told you, see the first part in the URL, www, then Forbes, then .com. That's it. This is official website of Forbes magazine. So this is news on the Forbes magazine that says Google will pay you if you can hack its phone. Okay. Google will pay you. If Google is saying so much, then their security must be really good. Then why do you think people say iOS has got better security? I'll tell you the reason. See, many of you might have used VidMate or maybe GB WhatsApp. That is why Android is less safer than iOS, because when you are using GB WhatsApp or when you are using VidMate or any app from outside Play Store, you have to turn off your security feature. You have to go into the settings, go into the security part and turn on install from unknown sources. That is where people make mistake. They install softwares outside of Play Store. Normally, when a software is uploaded in Play Store, it goes through checks, security checks, not just once, periodically it undergoes tests to check for any virus attack or malware or different things. But if you are installing from outside Play Store, there is chance your phone will get hacked. Probably if you are using GB WhatsApp or VidMate, hackers could use it, because we don't know, like you don't know from where exactly. Is it official GB WhatsApp? Or even if it's official, you don't know who is the person running it. There is no registration process, not just GB WhatsApp. There are other things. VidMate, for example, some company, yeah, I can say that VidMate is being run by a particular person, but you can never be sure about them, because the internet is a free space. Anybody can put any software they like, or you could use pirated softwares, APK files of Hotstar or some other apps that could tamper with your phone, that they could hack your phone, they could hack your data. So do not turn on installation from other sources. If you do that, you are inviting trouble yourself. It is not that iPhone is safer, it is just that Android has given you the ability to use your own app, so it gets a little weaker there. You do it yourself. And next, keep your passwords unique. Do not make your passwords very easy. Do not keep it your name, your parents' name, your pet name, your date of birth, your mobile number, etc. Try to keep your password a mix of different things, like 123, some capital letters, some small letters, and some symbols. Okay, some symbols. Mix all this and create a password, a random password. Then what else? Do not enter your keep a strong password. And if you ever feel like your phone has been hacked, normally it won't get hacked if you keep a strong password and follow all the rules. But there might come a time when like your phone starts vibrating a lot or you are not able to do anything. That does not mean your phone has been hacked. Usually it does not mean your phone has been hacked. What you have to do is, suppose now I'm using this thing and then a web page opens that makes my laptop to make beep sound. Okay, my laptop suddenly starts beeping. Or if I was using a phone, my phone starts vibrating and it shows a message, your phone has been hacked, do this, do that, send me your OTP or send me this much money in my account, etc. You do not have to panic, just go and close the tab, that's it. Nothing else, your phone has not been hacked. Okay, it is as simple as that. It's not so easy to hack your phone. Although if you turn on unknown sources, you are installing apps from here and there, saying your passwords to everybody, using every system that you find to check your Facebook, Gmail, etc., then your phone might get hacked. Or if you are not able to close the tab from here, then just restart your device. It is as simple as that. Then when you get any OTP, like you are making an online payment, if you are making payment and you get an OTP in your phone, then always read the whole message. What does the OTP say? Suppose you have to make payment of 90 rupees. So you might get message 90.00 rupees. So read it carefully. Is it 90.00 rupees or it is 9,000 rupees? Be careful there. Sometimes it happens that if you are making payment, not reputed websites, not Flipkart or Amazon, but some websites, if you try to make payment, they'll send you the wrong link and you will make the payment. Also, do not make payments online for the websites you do not know. Always do cash on delivery. Use only Play Store or whichever app store you have. Then if some website gives you huge discounts, if some website says we are giving you 90% discount, see this iPhone cost 1 lakh rupees, we will give you in 10,000 rupees. You just have to make 5,000 advance payment, or it says share to your 10 friends, 20 friends, then that website is fake. Understand, they are saying you to share. So that I showed you just now, if you share the details, your friends will register, they will get their mobile numbers, email IDs, and then they will disturb them with these things, customer care, with offers and all, they'll call. And if somebody is sending you money, to receive money, you don't need to enter any PIN, just your account number and IFSC code is enough. Or you can just give them your UPI ID. Your UPI ID is a combination of your name @UPI, or it is a combination of your mobile number @ if it is Paytm, then Paytm, or if it is Bheem app, then UPI, or if it is PhonePe, it will be @YBL. Just that, this number is enough, or your account number and IFSC. You don't have to give anything else. They might say, we have sent you money, one OTP has come, tell me that OTP and you will receive the money. Don't do that. Or if they say, scan this QR code and you will receive the money, do not scan QR code. QR code is for sending money. It is not for receiving money. Then, do not open websites which seem fishy. If you think that some website might be fake or some website might try to hack you, do not open that website. Okay. You don't know, but the website that I am showing you right now, this copy of this website has been already saved in my computer. Anything that you open in on the internet will be saved on your device. If you see a photo, it will be in your phone as cookies. Okay, so if you open a hacker's website, it will automatically store the data in your phone. It'll put a virus in your phone. Even though you don't download, you did not click on download, it will automatically get downloaded. So if you get a message in your email or SMS that you have won so much price, you just have to register and we'll send you the money. Don't do that. It is mostly fake. Okay, now we'll start with an overview of cybersecurity. Just let me check if I missed anything. Okay, we'll start.
Would you be comfortable living in a house that someone else had a key to? What if an underground tunnel led into it from a public park, where its windows could never quite close all the way? Would you trust it with your safety and your privacy? The internet is that house. This is not to say never go into the house, but rather, you should know the hazards before you store all of your valuables there, and do what you can to protect them.
Like I told, your phone or your data could be hacked or leaked. If you keep using many devices, nearly every device you find, always use trusted devices. Always use your own mobile phone, your own computer. Do not log in using anybody else's computer unless it is really important.
So why is it insecure, and why can't we just fortify it until it's safe? Well, first of all, the internet was not originally built to be what it is today. It's like someone decided to expand a shoebox into a skyscraper. The internet originally developed when computers were huge, skyscraper.
So the person is trying to say here that the internet was very small actually. It was like a shoebox, very small. But now it is like a skyscraper that is very huge. Why it says that is because the first internet developed was named ARPANET and it was to be used just by US military. But slowly it expanded and now everybody uses internet.
The internet originally developed when computers were huge and so expensive to own that only universities, big businesses, and a few governments had them. The point, originally, was to let these massive supercomputers talk to each other. And as soon as two computers could send information back and forth, we had a network. The network gradually grew until personal computers emerged in the 1980s, and then it exploded. Soon, people were not just talking to each other, but also exchanging money, playing games.
Just a minute.
Sandworm-like creatures?
Reading news, shopping, and doing everything we associate with the internet today. Other devices started talking to the network too. Phones and cars and refrigerators and elevators and power plants and much, much more. But the ease of all those devices talking to each other came at a price. Security. One computer could send another instructions to delete everything on it or take it over. We call these viruses and malware. Or one person could steal another's identity by guessing, cracking, or extracting a password. Vulnerabilities such as these will never completely go away because they're built into the internet's very architecture. Criminals use them to steal billions of dollars, governments use them for surveillance, and hacktivists use them to further their political goals.
Okay, so the person told one very important thing here was, just let me go back. The internet can be used to send files. Okay, we can do multiple transactions. Nearly everything is now connected to the internet. Your AC, your refrigerator, your car too. When autonomous cars come, they'll be connected to internet. Even now, cars are connected to the internet through GPS systems. So it was initially meant to transfer useful files, useful data. But now people can hack into the systems. Okay. They can destroy a system completely, like send a virus and destroy everything present in it. Take control of another system, like it will send in some virus and from your Instagram account, it will start posting stuffs. Okay, it will message everybody. You won't know. And by the time you get to know that your Instagram account has been hacked, it will be too late. Then other thing it can do is it can use, it can guess your password. Yeah, that is how it can guess your password and find out your data. One is it can destroy your data. Second is it can find out what your password is and access your data, get all your data. Third one is it can even change your data. How it is being used is by government to keep check on everybody. Like government is constantly tracking what you are doing, what I am doing, whom I am texting, where I am going, everything the government is able to see. Second one, the hackers, they do it to ask for money. Some do it even for fun.
Very architecture, such as these identity by control billions them to further their political. Governments, very architecture. Criminals use them to steal billions of dollars.
Criminals, like you can hack into bank servers and take all the money and the bank wouldn't know. And by the time they would know, like you could extract 1 rupee from everybody's account. It has been already done. Person. Okay, I'm not getting the news there, but once it had come that somebody, not 1 rupee actually, like 100 or 200 rupees from each account, some criminal took out, and everybody was like, okay, this 100 rupees only, no, maybe it is some fees. But then somebody went and complained, and then there was internal checking, and they got to know that somebody was stealing 100 or 200 rupees from each person. Now, just imagine if somebody is stealing 100 rupees daily from 1 lakh people's account, that would mean per day that person is earning 1 crore rupees.
Governments use them for surveillance and hacktivists use
them. Hacktivists use them to further their political goal. This means they'll hack the system. Suppose if somebody does not like Indian government, then they'll hack Indian government's website. If somebody doesn't like Pakistan government, they will hack Pakistan government's website. Or maybe if somebody does not like that we are learning this stuff on this website, they'll hack this website and put something else. That is what hacktivist means. A hacker, that is an activist.
Them to further their political goals. Between 2004 and 2013, over 1 billion records. As a thought experiment, let's imagine what a perfectly secure internet might look like. Users would not be allowed to download or install anything onto their computers. All internet traffic would be monitored and install anything secure internet might look like.
So here they are explaining as an experiment. Let us imagine what a perfectly secure internet might look like. In the next sentence, he says, user will not be able to download or install any software. That is what happens in the case of iOS or iPhones or iPads. You will not be able to download anything outside of their Play Store. So your phone will, your iPhone will not get hacked. Whereas the same applies for Android. However, it has given you the ability to download. It has left on its own customers. That is why people say Android is not safe, because you get it in your hand and you are destroying it. But simply you are blaming it on Android. If you were not turning that feature off or you are not downloading some file, then your phone would, your Android phone would be as safe as iPhone.
Users would not be allowed to download or install anything onto their computers. All internet traffic would be monitored and regulated by bots and humans, massively limiting the number of websites you could visit. In order to log on to a website, you'd have to type in a 100-character password, submit a genetic sample, and whistle a tune.
Okay, so here they are saying everything would be monitored and regulated. Like if you are trying to check and open any website, suppose I want to open Amazon, then are you all able to hear me?
Yes.
Okay, so if you are trying to visit Amazon, what actually happens is, I have explained this before also, the servers, I have explained what servers are and how they work. See, when you try to access Amazon website, what will happen there is an Amazon server, and here you are a user. So first you will type and send that I want to access amazon.in. Now there might be .com or .in or .uk or .au, that is Australia. So there will be many things. So you send in, you want in, then Amazon will send you a file of amazon.in. Now what will happen here, this is very fast, but if you want it secure, that yes, you have received that file, that particular file from Amazon, Amazon company, original Amazon company, and Amazon should be sure that you are a user, then we'll place some bots, okay? Some robots here. Each time you send the information, this particular bot will check it. And each time Amazon sends in the data, this bot will check it. That will take a lot of time. Although you have firewalls, it's called firewall in the system, which checks all these things. But still, if you want even more secure, it will take even more time. And you will have to keep your passwords really strong.
By bots and humans, massively limiting the number of websites.
Because you'll have to wait for so long, you won't be able to visit the website so fast, and as a result, you won't be able to use many websites. Because by the time one website opens, it will be like opening, suppose you have to open 10 websites, but in that much time, only one website will open.
Websites you can visit. In order to log on to a website, you have to type in a 100-character password, submit a genetic sample, and whistle a tune. The servers that hold data would be kept in heavily armed fortresses on the moon. And even with all these safeguards in place, some clever hacker would almost certainly still find a way in.
So it is saying, what are the different ways? Ultimately though, a hacker will be able to find its way. There is no such thing as 100% safe internet. Or like anytime your data can be hacked, there is huge chance. Now it depends like what system you are using. Whether you are installing some file outside of Play Store or Microsoft Store, whether you are using licensed software or pirated software, whether you are watching original movies or pirated movies, all those things matter. So So it's up to you to keep the security in check. Still, your data might get hacked, but the good thing is something is better than nothing. So at least you take care of your data. Like every lock can be broken. Similarly, no matter how strong security you build for the internet, it can be broken by a good hacker.
The good news is, even with our flawed internet, there are simple things you can do to protect yourself. And there are a lot of people committed to making the internet more secure. In Nova's cybersecurity lab, you'll play as one of these people, protecting a company that's the target of increasingly sophisticated cyber attacks. You must continuously strengthen your defenses to thwart these attackers. You'll do this by completing challenges that will give you basic coding abilities, help you spot scams designed to trick you into giving up your secrets, and teach you
Okay, I hope you can see this picture clearly. See the spelling of Google. Are you able to make it here? Hello, can you see? Can you tell me what is written here?
It's zero.
Yes, it is zero. G00GLE. Which means this is, although it is like .com before .com, after, before the first slash, if you see, there is a .com and there is Google. But if you see carefully, this is zero, which means you should not enter your details here. If you enter your details here, what it will do is it will go to the original website and it will enter your details and it will be able to see your mail, your photos, your call history, your SMS, OTPs, and not only that, your location as well. Your browsing history, your phone password, your banking password, banking OTPs, number of bank accounts, which place you visit, which place you eat, which place you sleep, everything will be in their hands. So always check that it is accounts.google.com. Always within these two slashes or within www. It should always be accounts.google.com. At least this part has to be google.com. The last part should be .co.in or .com, and before that, just before that, should be proper Google.
Designed to trick you into giving up your secrets and teach you how passwords are cracked and strengthened. The house that is the internet may be built on a shaky foundation, but it's been a home to innovation and an unprecedented free exchange of ideas. It's up to us to make it livable in spite of its flaws.
Like here you see, this is twitter.com/NovaLabs, which means this .com website is fine. Now, if suppose there was another link on this web page, if I were to open twitter.com/TheNovaLabs, okay, TheNovaLabs. Now, see, there are many things in this Twitter thing, Twitter. Like see here, there is one link here, another link is here itself. Now, as long as you are on Twitter, you are safe. But if you click this link, you will be taken to another website. Again, you have to repeat the same thing. You have to check the website. What is this website? Before the first dash is ORG, which stands for organization. Before that is PBS. Now you have to know whether this PBS is trustworthy or not. So I'll just do one small search. Okay, it is just pbs.com, which means you can trust it. If like it does not ask for your bank details and all, you can trust it to learn things. We have completed this. Now next one. Top 10 steps to cyber security. Just a minute, some new people joined. I'll allow them to speak. Nisarga Maitli, and I don't know who is this person. Just a heart. Okay, so 10 steps to cyber security. First, network security. Protect your networks from attack. Defend their network perimeter. Filter out unauthorized access and malicious content. Monitor and test security controls. That means, if you are setting up an internet, do not allow anybody to touch your modem except for the person who comes to fix it. Okay, just the person who is fixing your internet
should be allowed to touch your modem or your internet wire and nobody else. Just a right. Then user education and awareness. You have to learn it yourself. Also, you have to tell others about it, like how to maintain cyber security and all, how to maintain security in your computer or in your phone. Malware protection. Produce relevant policies, anti-malware defense across your organization. So you have to keep certain antiviruses, and also you have to make some rules and regulations that if anybody sees like this file, then they should come and tell us. Removable media content. That is, if you are working, or like if you have got a laptop or a phone, then you have to control what is getting copied in it. If somebody sends you WhatsApp image also, even that you should think before downloading, because I think Amazon's CEO Jeff Bezos phone was hacked from a WhatsApp image. I think so. Just a minute, let me check. See, it was hacked from a WhatsApp message in 2018. From a WhatsApp message, okay, that is how it got hacked. Now, secure configuration, you have to apply security patches. Security patches means the company. If I'm using Dell, then Dell. If I'm using HP, HP, Windows, Windows, Android, Android, MI, MI, it's up to them. They will send you security patches. As soon as a new virus comes into the market, then they will create their own antivirus and they'll send it. So you have to keep your phone updated, apply security patches. Then manage user privileges. You have to decide yourself who has access to your phones, who has access to your computers. And also you have to monitor user activity, who is logging in at what time, all those things. Incident management. As soon as something happens, you have to report it and take him to the court or her to the court. Monitoring, the same thing. You have to keep checking everything, that your network is working fine. Every now and then go check the modem, whether your modem is working fine or not, or if some new thing has been attached to it or what. Home and mobile working. You have to, if you have got staff at your home, you have to teach them how to use the things. They should not just bring in a pen drive and connect it to your TV or your computer. They should ask your permission and you should scan it for viruses. Future of cyber security in healthcare. I'll just go fast. When malicious actors gain access to accounts, whether by weak password. So there are two ways mainly by which they get your get access to your account. That is, if you have a weak password, they'll guess it. If you keep your pet name, pet's name, your school name, or if you keep it date of birth or mobile number, they'll get to know. They'll get to know all that. They'll be able to guess it and they can hack into your system. Second one is phishing attack. This phishing, just now I showed you in the video, it was Google, like G-00-G-L-E. That is how phishing happens. It will not be the actual website. It will try to copy the website. You will enter your details there and your phone or whatever it is, your data will get hacked. Now, there is like why it is required, why security is required in healthcare. That is because So if you check the machines present in hospitals, that is like 20-25 years old. And right now it is like every day one new virus comes out, which could potentially hack the system. So you have to install certain software in those old devices. You have to create such a system that those devices cannot be accessed by anyone outside the hospital. Why do you need so? Well, the devices, there are many life-saving devices. Some control your heart rate, some control somebody's respiration and other things. So if somebody gets access to those devices, they could kill many people, or they could just disturb the hospital. Like one hospital might hack other hospitals. systems and turn off the lights during an operation, it will be very bad reputation. Okay, so you need good security there. Just a minute. You have to monitor device behavior. If some device is working properly, it will work with a flow. But if some device is malfunctioning, then you have to check for anomalies. That is why it is happening. And you have to get it repaired soon. Five main types of cyber security. I'll go one after the other. I'll go soon. Okay, just a minute. I'll zoom in on it. Okay, it's not happening. I'll just keep it as it was. Can you all see what is on the screen here?
It's a...
Okay, then I'll read. Okay, so there are five types of cyber security. One is critical infrastructure. This is critical in the sense many people's lives depend on it, such as electricity grid. If electricity goes off, many lives will be affected, such as in hospitals or even on roads. Not just that, most of our work is done using electricity now. Water purification. If electricity is affected, then even water purification will be affected, traffic lights will be affected, shopping centers and hospitals. These are some of the very critical critical systems that need to be protected from cyber attacks. Okay, then there is application security. That is your particular application, such as WhatsApp or Facebook or Instagram. Now, to prevent that, you need antivirus program or firewalls. Firewalls means only the trusted people can access it. Like if you are connecting to our internet, then whatever data you get, it will pass through a firewall and it will check whether this data is safe or not. Then encryption program, in the sense how we have on WhatsApp. What encryption program means is you will have a message. A message will be sent in the form of a lock and the other person will have the key. Only you and that other person can read it, as similar to what is seen in WhatsApp. Then network security. I already told what network security is. It is on the internet, okay, on the internet, related to the internet. The same thing, encryption, firewall, anti-spyware. Spyware means somebody, spy, you already know what a spy is. One who keeps track on you, who is always watching you, who is seeing all your moves. So anti-spyware software, in the sense, one that prevents such attacks. Antivirus, virus is something that can be used to attack your system, delete your system, take control of it as well. Take all your data, so you need antivirus software. You have to keep creating new passwords, always keep changing your password, and you have to go into the each account, whether it is your Google account or Instagram account, and check where all it is logged in. It is there in both Google account as well as Instagram account. You can go and check how many devices are you logged in right now. Everybody, please go and check this thing. Many of you might be shocked that your login information is in some other device as well. That other person can also use it. Go and check. I'll tell you how. You can watch this video later. After I end the video, watch it again. When I upload, you have to open the Google app in your phone. And then afterwards, click on your DP on the top right corner. Then click on Manage Google Account. Then go into the security part. just a minute, I'll do. Okay, you have to go into the security part, and then you can find out web activity or like known devices or something like that, and you check if some device you do not recognize, log out from there. Cloud security, I already told you what cloud is. So security of that thing is called cloud security. You need two things: on-premise environment, user experience. Okay, sorry, this is a different thing. This is the number of attacks. On-premise environment, user experience, in the sense, if you are working in a bank, then that bank got hacked from within the bank itself. Okay, from that particular location. Service provider means, like I told you, Amazon or Google and such things, those got hacked. Your bank did not get hacked. The company from which you are taking the service, that got hacked. Internet of Things, I have already explained what Internet of Things is. That is, this security is related to that. Then five essential elements of cyber security. I'll end the class in 10 minutes. An effective framework. Now you need to understand what is important and what is not important. It is not that you need security for each and every data. Some data might be more important than the other, so you need better security there. Some data, it's like, it doesn't matter. Like if you are keeping a tab of, I can't get an example, but say some data is not so important. Yeah, suppose if you have got textbook, if you take example of our college, then there are many textbooks. Now those textbooks are already present in the public domain. Anybody can get those textbooks. Whatever is in the library, anybody can get it. So you do not, if you are uploading it on the website of our college, then you do not have to provide it so much security that somebody will steal it. Although you have to provide a security that nobody should be able to change it, but you don't have to worry much about somebody seeing it. You do not have to worry about somebody checking it. So you need to know what exactly you need. Then end-to-end scope. You need to find out each and every device that is connected to your network. Not only that, you also need to know who all are using your network, who all are using your company's softwares, and who are using your company's laptops or phones. Through risk assessment and threat modeling, this is, you have to think by yourself. If you have got a mobile phone, then you should think it yourself what items could be stolen from your mobile phone and be used by hackers to blackmail you, and what are the things that if those got leaked out, it wouldn't pay much, it wouldn't make much difference. You have to know. That is what risk assessment means. Threat modeling, that is you try to hack yourself. Also, like, it's like ethical hacking. Proactive incident response planning. You have to be prepared from beforehand that if ever your system gets hacked, what will you do? Which person will you call? Which developer will you call? Or which wire will you pull out? Dedicated cybersecurity resource. You have to keep one separate team to fight cybersecurity. You cannot be dependent on the website. Like there is somebody who is making website. You cannot be dependent on that. You have to keep a dedicated cybersecurity person. That was 5, here it is 8. Let's just check it once. Okay, this part is easy. I have read it already. I'll explain. 9, 10, I'll end the class. These are some numbers, you have to read it yourself. I am not going to explain each and everything here. If those are just numbers, read it yourself, you'll understand. Effect, loss of strategic information. What does it mean is, it means suppose you created a strategy that next week you are going to launch new mobile phone, then your that thing gets released in public domain even before you have released it. Or you are producing a new film, new movie, and it gets released before you can officially announce it. So you won't get money. Damage to reputation. Obviously, if your system is hacked, your reputation will be damaged, that you do not have proper security. Other than that, hackers could use your account to post things without your knowledge. That will also destroy your reputation. Loss of data and equipments. They could delete all your photos, videos, call records, call logs, anything. And not just that, they could destroy your whole mobile phone or your whole computer. They could just put in some code that will overheat your phone and it will blast. Loss of intellectual property. This is in the sense many companies build their own software. That is what called intellectual property. Revenue loss, your bank account. From that, they could take out your money. Regulatory penalties using this same thing. Damage to reputation, like they'll hack your system and they'll do certain things that goes against the law, and then government will catch you. Not law, sorry, law. Then court settlement and fees, same thing. Increased cost of capital. Once your system gets hacked, you have got two things that you can do. One, find a cybersecurity expert. Two, just throw away the device, start using another device. So it will cost you money. Increased PR expense, that is public relations, that I don't know how. Loss in market value. This market value means in the share market, like Tata Motors, if I show you, okay, Tata Teleservice, this is the market value. This is the market value, 48,000 crores. No, sorry, 48 trillion crores, I think. I don't know what exactly 1,000 crores or trillion crores. Not just this, like loss in market value, like Android has less market value as compared to iPhone. That is because iPhone, people believe, cannot be hacked. However, it is not so. Even iPhone can be hacked, but it has made a name for itself. And Android has lost the market value because people think it can be hacked, although it's not true. No, just the value has increased, but the number of people using Android is far more than iOS. These are also some numbers. So 73% of the hacking or breaches were done by outsiders, whereas 28 were done by internal people. Okay. Then 48% meant hacking, 30% included malware. Malware is a piece of software that will be installed on your system. Okay. Hacking could be anything. It could be installing the software, taking your software, or deleting it, changing it, modifying it, or posting on your behalf. All that comes under hacking. Whereas breaches include malware, means it will just install a software which will be able to do everything. Hacking means the person is malware comes under hacking. Okay. Non-POS malware was delivered via email. Non-POS means this is a machine, point of sale machine, POS machine. This machine, when you are using this machine, you get to see what amount you are entering, what amount transaction you are doing. However, 49% of non-POS means outside that machine was delivered via email. You get an email, you click on that, enter your details, and next moment the money from your account is gone. 76% of the time it was for the money, the hacking, and 68% of the time for many months people did not know their data was being leaked or their phones or systems were hacked. 58% of the time, victims were small business. Don't think that only Amazon, Flipkart, Yahoo, Google, Facebook, all will be hacked. Even small businesses get hacked. Small businesses get hacked because the security is less. 24% of the time, it was healthcare organizations. 50% it was done by criminal groups. Not by a single person, but 50% was done in groups. Then how can you do that? There are password managers that keep checking your password, where you store your password and you don't have to remember anything. That manager will remember everything. It is a piece of software, and also it will keep checking if your password is a copy of someone else's password, and it will immediately tell you your password is weak, please change it. Now, what you should do if you have a company, revoke access, that is remove access of an employee after he leaves the organization. And randomize every password, that is, do not make a password like, suppose my name is Ahtasham, so for me the college will give me password Ahtasham123, and there is Nakshay for them, the college gives Nakshay123, for Sahana they give Sahana123, and for Ankit they give Ankit123, and for Supriya they give Supriya123. No, you should not keep the password like that. The password has to be random. random in the sense you just type in something and then you make this thing only password. Okay, I know it's tough to remember, but that is how you protect your privacy. Then increase accountability for shared credentials. That is, sometimes it happens, the same user ID and same password will be used by multiple people. In that case, you have to increase the accountability, means who is using when. You need to log in each and every time. Apply role-based permission to passwords. That is, if it is an admin, give him full permission. If it is a student, give him less permission. That depends on your passwords. Requires multi-factor authentication. That is, first you enter the password in your Google account or something. Second, you get one OTP. You have to enter both. Only then your account will open. Everybody go now and change your system, Instagram system, and as well as your WhatsApp system and also your Google system, to two-factor authentication. That way, even if somebody got your password, they will not be able to log in unless they get your phone or your SMS. Now, the downside is that the negative side is that if you forget your second password, you cannot gain access to your account. Your WhatsApp will be deleted completely. Your Facebook or Instagram or Gmail will be deleted completely. So you have to remember the second password. Identify your passwords. Virtual private network, VPN. What happens here is, just a minute, I'll explain this one thing and I'll finish it. Blockchain, I have already explained. This one we'll do tomorrow. It's late. Just VPN, I'll explain, okay? Is it fine? Shall I explain VPN? It'll take like 2-3 minutes.
Okay, no problem.
What happens? Okay, here only. So, like I explained in my previous previous Jamboard, the same thing applies here. Normally, when suppose this is you, user, and this is Amazon. Normally, what happens is you send in that I want to open Amazon. It will be mentioned on your query. Like you type in Amazon.in or Amazon.com, it will be written. And then next, Amazon will send you the file, the website. On that also, it will be written that it is Amazon website. Okay. Now, what happens here is there is your network provider like Airtel. Airtel, or there is Jio. Okay. Or there is India government. Government of India. There is government of India. They can see what you are trying to do. They will be able to see, okay, you are asking for Amazon and some website is sending you an Amazon website. Okay, it will be an open thing. However, if at the same place you installed one software that is known as VPN, you use one VPN, then what happens here is when you send in a data, you say, I want Amazon, but what this VPN will do is it will cut it into so many parts. It will encrypt it, it will cut it into so many parts, it won't look like Amazon. It looks something like this. Okay, it'll look something like this. The government or your service provider such as Jio or Airtel will not be able to understand what is this. Then this particular piece of data will go to some server in some other country, probably Greenland or some other country. It depends where it is stored. And there will be another system which will identify, okay, this thing means Amazon. Then that system will send the data to Amazon website. And then Amazon will send that data to this website, to the VPN company. Okay, it will send it to the VPN company. And then again, next moment, what VPN does is it will create this, create that software. VPN will create that software in smaller pieces, okay, in a very different way, and send it to you. And because you are using VPN, this will be able to understand and it will give you the proper file. Arthaita, VPN Andre?
Yes.
Okay, then fine. I'll end the class here. Next, we'll continue tomorrow. But just a minute. Do not end the class now. I wanted to show you something. Just give me a minute. There is a video. Are you all still here? Okay, yeah, you are here. Just there is some two classes that I want to attend. by yourself. It is very good one. Go to the Infosys Springboard. Go to the Infosys Springboard and look for time management. Okay. Just a minute. Look for time management. Search for time management. There are two courses there. One is of 52 minutes. Another one is for 20 minutes. Okay. So at least do this 20 minutes course. It's actually not 20 minutes. It is 10 minutes, I feel. Just a minute. It has got two videos. Okay, so it has got only these many videos, three videos, okay. I think it has got two videos and one this thing, one article. Just go and read. It is really nice. Okay, it will be helpful to you. Fine, then I'll end the class here. Bye, everybody. Do check this out.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.